To commemorate 1 year since the overturning of Roe v. Wade, the pro-life group Live Action, in its 20th year of defending life, held a press conference at the U.S. Capitol. Their message to Congress, it's time to enact 14th Amendment protections for children in the womb. Live Action says this is the, quote, new North Star for the pro-life movement. The press conference featured speakers from the pro-life groups Human Coalition, Students for Life, and others, who say it's not enough for abortion to be legislated on the state level alone. We talked to Rose after the press conference. We bring you that interview right now. We're here with Lila Rose, president and founder of Live Action. We just wrapped up the new North Star event. So talk to me about what the new North Star is for the pro-life movement from your perspective, Lila.
In the wake of the overruling of Roe v. Wade, which was the most unjust Supreme Court decision in our history, the North Star for the movement is acknowledging equal protection under the law without compromise for all human beings born and preborn. Yes. And this is already promised under our Constitution, under the 14th Amendment, which has an equal protection clause. So already today in America, preborn children have a constitutional right to life, and it is now time for the federal and all state law to reflect that.
Right, right. And Lila, we have to be honest, this is kind of a debate. You know, there are some pro-life groups saying that we should be kind of taking a more incremental approach. Live Action is saying that we should be calling for full protection for preborn children. So how have you been viewing that debate as it plays out on Capitol Hill with members of Congress, among leaders in the movement? What's your take?
So the large majority of the pro-life movement, leading pro-life groups and legal experts support Live Action's new North Star strategy, saying that absolutely we already have legal protection under the 14th Amendment for preborn children. Of course, the federal and the state government should reflect that. So yes, of course, there is dissent among how that's to be enacted, especially when it comes to political strategies during elections, what candidates should or shouldn't say. But at the end of the day, we need bold and uncompromising leadership in the pro-life movement. This is the most important human rights issue of the day. We're talking about the lives of innocent children. So, and we're talking about basic fundamental human rights, constitutional rights. So now is the time for bold vision, uncompromising progress, and we can do that if we keep that North Star of complete legal protection as already promised by our Constitution for all human beings born and preborn.
And we know that changing the laws isn't the only part of this fight. You know, it's about changing the culture, changing the way people think about abortion as well. You recently debated Dr. Phil on this issue. You've been going on more secular podcasts to chat about this with people who are big influences in the culture on social media. So how do you see the debate in terms of changing hearts and minds going?
Yeah, I think people, deep down, many people are naturally pro-life. There's a natural instinct to protect. There's a natural instinct that we have towards justice. Yes, murder is always wrong. Homicide is always wrong. And so it's really connecting the dots for people that the thing that they've been lied to for decades, that abortion that they've been told is a reproductive right, is good for women, is actually the direct and intentional killing of a child. And that child has human rights, like you and me, and that child deserves protection. When that case is made and those dots are connected for people, when they're presented with the scientific reality of life in the womb, minds change. We see this all the time at Live Action. And it also is important to cut back or push back against the narrative coming from the pro-abortion side that women are somehow harmed when we abolish abortion. No, abortion has never been about women's rights. Abortion has always been about the oppression of preborn children. And we've been lying to women now for decades to say that we've been advanced when we haven't. We should provide health care for both mother and child and meet the needs of women instead of saying you need to kill your child in order to solve a problem or a crisis that you're facing.
Let's talk a little bit about what we're up against with the White House here. President Biden, he's pushing for extreme policies on abortion. He has been since the overturn of Roe, calling for the codification of Roe. He released an executive order today saying that he's going to expand access to contraception. Talk to me about how that plays into this battle.
Well, we are facing the most pro-abortion administration in our history. The president of the United States has said that he wants abortion on demand for any reason. He wants to remove any abortion restriction or regulation. He wants taxpayer funding for abortion. He wants to codify abortion when, in fact, there's a constitutional right to life and a right to equal protection under our laws for all human beings in this country, born and preborn. And the White House is refusing to acknowledge the scientific reality of when life even begins. And so we have to fight back against the lies coming from this administration, from the radical pro-abortion policies coming from this administration. And in terms of, you know, I don't know if you want me to comment specifically on the contraception.
Yes, yeah.
I mean, in terms of the president pushing for more abortion and more contraception, we know that throwing contraception around is not going to stop the abortion crisis. In fact, 50% of women who are on contraception in the month they get pregnant were actually 50% of women who have abortions were actually on contraception in the month that they got pregnant. So we know that abortion isn't stopped by contraception. In fact, contraception increases the societal misunderstanding of sex, that somehow sex should be divorced from the ability to bring life and from family and from marriage. The sexual revolution has actually created the abortion problem, because we look at sex in the wrong way now, and promiscuity and sex without responsibility has led to the abortion rate. So to throw contraception at the problem is actually going to only increase the problem of abortion. And it's no surprise coming from this administration, though, because they are pro-abortion, and they don't, they're not fighting for marriage and families.
Right, right. Just one more question before we wrap up. So, you know, we are here celebrating the year anniversary of the overturn of Roe, and we're standing right in front of the Capitol where the laws are made on the federal level. So what is your message to lawmakers right now moving forward, and what do you hope to see a year from now?
The message to lawmakers is this: you have a sacred responsibility and obligation to defend the Constitution, and that includes the 14th Amendment, the equal protection for all human beings. So any law that in any way infringes on the rights of our preborn brothers and sisters is an unjust and unconstitutional law. And in fact, you have the responsibility to create law that reflects these constitutional rights, especially where these rights are being violated. And that would be law to protect children from the violence of abortion. Not just some children, but all children without compromise.